Counterfeit and substandard agro products have persisted on the market despite the concerns raised by farmers and other concerned citizens on several occasions. The latest findings by anti-counterfeit networks have still indicated that 50% of the agro inputs, such as seeds and chemicals on the market, are counterfeit. The research finding was carried out with the farmers in several parts of the country. Substandard products not only affect the country's economy and people's well-being, but also threaten food security and the country's agriculture products for export.
Because it's more expensive, actually, to buy counterfeits, more expensive. Because you fall sick, you get injured, and actually spend much more money trying to treat yourself. As they say, ignorance is very expensive. Many of the consumers are engaging in non-perceptive consumption. In other words, they are buying counterfeits unknowingly, but the consequences are disastrous. But also, counterfeits are a danger to your wealth as well, because you spend much more regularly when you buy a fake product, because it will not deliver. If you are in agriculture, you buy fake seeds, you will not get a harvest.
Fred Mwema, the legal and corporate affairs officer at Anti-Counterfeit Network, blames the weak laws for the persistent substandard products on the market. He noted that stringent laws to fight counterfeit products on the market are needed as early as yesterday.
There is no justification for consuming counterfeits if you know the danger. There is no poor person who will knowingly give their child poisoned food, contaminated food, and damage their liver and lose their child when they know. A lot of the consumption of counterfeits is caused by ignorance. And we have been poor as a country. Uganda has been a poor country since independence. But we never used to have counterfeits in the 60s and 70s. What happened?
The development was put to light during the sensitization workshop of agriculture police and lawyers on the rising cases of counterfeit products. They were challenged to take interest in such cases whenever they are brought before them. Fred Muzira, an agriculture officer in the Ministry of Agriculture, cautioned farmers to be very vigilant as they purchase agro inputs. Among the things they need to avoid is buying these products from hawkers, avoid non-receipt items, non-branded products, and cheap products, among others.
And the ministry is taking serious strides to make sure that some of these issues are addressed. And one of the biggest appeal that we make to the farmers one, fighting counterfeits or substandard inputs lies partly with the farmers, that we need to tell our farmers that the number of things that they need to do, that one, price should never be the ultimate goal for buying inputs. Don't go to a shop or a market where people are buying inputs and you're duped because somebody is offering you a price slightly lower than the other inputs.
Some of the common tricks used by the dealers to adulterate. Take two. Some of the common tricks used by the dealers to adulterate the agrochemical products, including diluting the products, placing a label for an expensive product on a cheap product, and selling it exorbitantly. Story compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.